rampant drug abuse within the psychiatric system.
Romesh Senewiratne was working as a GP in his own private practice in Melbourne until earlier this year. Following his marriage breakup in January, he decided to take some time off to pursue his own research into alternatives to Western medicine. He's especially interested in holistic approaches to treating mental illness. His practice brought in around $120,000 a year, and his decision to employ a locum to run it for a while prompted members of his family to question the state of his mental health. In March, they had him committed to Royal Park Hospital, a psychiatric institution in Melbourne. Romesh was diagnosed with a condition called hypomania, but a report prepared by a Melbourne psychiatrist just weeks ago cast doubt on that diagnosis. It said, quote, had his abrupt changes in his practice and his personal lifestyle been the result of hypomania, one would almost inevitably expect that the individual involved would resile from such beliefs and behaviour when calmness and well-being returned. In contrast, Dr. Senewiratne has no current evidence of psychiatric illness, remains committed to a different lifestyle, and has appropriate practical concerns and perhaps appropriate anger at having had compulsory psychiatric treatment.
Not to think as well. So all they do is drug people if they disagree with them. So I understood that the basic answer is you don't disagree with psychiatrists, you don't joke with them because they haven't got a sense of humour, and you talk to them very slowly because if you talk a bit fast they can't understand you. And that's how I got out.
That was Dr. Romesh Senewiratne in October of last year. Since then, the doctor has in health and in December of last year presented a paper at Monash University on the physiology of the midbrain and autonomic nervous system. Further good news for Romesh came on February 26 of this year when he was reinstated by the Medical Registration Board of Victoria to resume his practice as a doctor, something he fully intended doing. But the story did not end there. 3 days later, on February 29, a community assessment team from Monash Medical Centre came to his house and detained him under the authorisation of the Chief Psychiatrist of Victoria, Dr. Carlisle Pereira. He was in turn acting on the
enforced imprisonment from last year.
Sarah DeGeneva is a friend of Dr. Senewiratne. She was at his home on the night of February 29 when the Monash CAT team came to detain him.
Well, the CAT team came around with the police. Basically, I asked the lady at the CAT team, why were they taking Romesh in? On what grounds were they taking him in? She said that she was just doing her job, that she had the legal papers. I overheard her, though, say to the policeman that Romesh was deluded. So I asked her why she thought that he was deluded. And she said on the basis that he didn't have his medical registration back, which in fact he did. Mm-hmm. He was then taken away by the policeman, dragged out of here by the policeman.
And you've been with Romesh on, you've accompanied him on subsequent visits to Monash Medical Centre. What have you seen happen on these visits?
Basically that the psychiatrists are confused. They're getting two different stories. They're not really willing to listen to Romesh's evidence that he has.
Romesh spent the next 2 weeks at Monash Medical Centre, where he was injected with an antipsychotic drug for the treatment of the condition known as hypomania. This was despite the doctors not actually being sure that that was the condition from which he suffered.
Now, hypomania is described in psychiatric textbooks as not being a mental illness, but possibly being a mental abnormality. However, hypomania is a description of a happy, motivated person. It's characterized by elevated mood, which is an improved mood, increasing goal-directed activities, which is increased motivation, supposedly unrealistic optimism, and abnormal sociability and friendliness, and impulsiveness, which really means spontaneity. These are just descriptions of really a carefree, spontaneous person. Now, Christofiak was the registrar of it.
That was me in 1995 in October on Public Radio News. It was a story done by Sharon Lee on psychiatric abuses, which I had experienced and witnessed in the public hospital system in Melbourne and Brisbane in 1995. Public Radio News did another story in April 1996, after I had been locked up again in Melbourne, for my continued attacks on psychiatry and psychiatric abuses, as well as the huge amount of excess drugs that are used within the psychiatric system in Australia. This had been my initial concern in early 1995, when I started questioning the use of major tranquilizers, particularly haloperidol and other major tranquilizers used in the treatment of schizophrenia and supposed psychoses. I was also concerned at the huge escalation in the use of Prozac and other antidepressants, and deaths from tricyclic antidepressants like prozaden and triptanol, which are often fatal in overdose. I was concerned that suicide was being attributed to a mental illness rather than being attributed to the drugs that people were successfully killing themselves with. I was also concerned with the huge amount of use of amphetamines for treatment of attention deficit disorder and the huge escalation in this diagnosis. What I was concerned about, in other words, was psychiatry and the process of labeling people as abnormal according to criteria in psychiatric textbooks, particularly the American Psychiatric Association's DSM series. This series of books is the mainstay of psychiatric diagnosis in Australia in the courts of law, as well as in America, although there is a large civil rights movement in America against psychiatric abuses, and these abuses have been widely documented and exposed in America. In Australia, the system is far worse. There is an indiscriminate use of drugs within the public hospital system, often in large and toxic combinations. There is a huge amount of shock treatment used in hospitals and used against people's wills. People are locked up against their will and kept in there as long as they refuse to take drugs. They're kept in there claiming that they have lack of insight into their mental illness. I didn't know the full story of the psychiatric abuses going on in Australia until I spent 4 months locked up in the psychiatric system myself, during which time I accumulated many different diagnoses. Nobody really seemed to know how to label a person who was logically disproving the fundamental tenets of psychiatry, such as the concept of fixed personality. I didn't believe that anybody should be labeled with having negative personality traits and suggesting that such traits are fixed. I had become interested in Buddhist philosophy for 5 years or so before all of this happened, and I was very aware of concepts of change and the importance of change and the possibilities of change. This to me was contradicted by the psychiatric idea of premorbid personality or fixed personality. This was the beginning of my questioning of psychiatry generally, and it was a story that continued from 1995 till the present.